Good evening, friends. Paul here. Tonight's chat is about brainwaves, subject I've been researching recently. Very interesting. I'm going to put up a diagram here of the main brainwaves that we experience from very high frequency gamma waves, 32 to 100 hertz. 1 hertz is one cycle. Okay, so the electromagnetic cycles and gamma waves in the brain, very high intensity waves, is from 32 to 100 cycles per second. That's referred to as frequency. Gamma waves are lower amplitude, which, think of it as the y-axis or the vertical axis of waves, waveforms, as compared all the way to the bottom, the delta waves, which are very high amplitude, equating to high energy output, a higher electromagnetic energy. However, as you can see, a much lower frequency of 0.5 to 4 hertz, 0.5 to 4 cycles per second, when we are in our deepest dreamless sleep. This is when body repair takes place with our systems and tissues, etc. And very interesting that the delta phase of our sleep is the most high energy yet lowest frequency. You know what, guys? I equate this to like radio waves, where gamma and beta waves are very high frequency, like FM radio, however, with a very short range. So you've got very clear signal, very high frequency. However, low energy, short range, as compared to AM, which can bounce off the ionosphere at night and travel hundreds, sometimes thousands of miles, very long wavelengths in the AM radio band, and with a higher amplitude as well, traveling great distances. So that's how I kind of square this stuff up in my head. It's interesting, our beta waves from 13 to 32 hertz is just when we're awake, conscious, alert. And you know, the back to gamma, beta can be in where we're in a heightened state either of cognition or stress, or when, you know, our brain is just on overload and we're just, you know, thinking a mile a minute and sometimes having maybe trouble slowing down our thoughts, can be in those gamma, certainly in the gamma waves stage, possibly beta. Alpha is a state of relaxation, mentally and physically relaxed, 8 to 13 cycles per second. You know, it's interesting, just going over this stuff, we can feel when we're getting into a relaxed state. Like right now, I'm doing this video for you guys, and yeah, I'm thinking about it as I'm going along here and explaining this stuff. However, my brain is probably in, I would say, between an alpha and a beta stage right now. A lot of times when you're zoning out at night, maybe reading, watching a YouTube video, you're definitely going to be in the alpha range. Now, theta, this is interesting. The theta stage, it's been something I've been thinking a lot about lately, as occasionally I may take a late afternoon nap or try to or lie down for a little while, but not quite fall asleep. Yet I'm noticing lately that I'm in a dream state. I'm actually having dreams, but I can feel that I'm just not going into the delta phase of sleep where I'm just conked out sometimes. And that's theta, because theta is the dream state, responsible also for creativity, meditation, reduced consciousness, when we're just letting go and our subconscious begins to kick in the theta stage. Just late this afternoon I was doing that. I lied down for a little while trying to take a nap, but I just couldn't quite plug into deep sleep. But I was having these like mini dreams, like several of them, but then I was fully aware that, you know, I was kind of snapping right out of them. I just was not going into the delta, the restorative, the repairing sleep. We sleep in 90-minute cycles, which is interesting. We'll go through the whole range of these, or many of the ranges, say from alpha through delta, 90-minute increments throughout the evening. Also interesting to note, guys, that into adulthood, women experience greater delta wave frequency than men. That's right. Through my research, I found that out, that women experience more delta wave deep sleep, dreamless, deep, reparative, restorative sleep than men. Also, on a metaphysical level, some stuff I've been reading, and it's interesting to think about, is that the delta, the unconscious waves, are potentially when we are accessing the universe or the collective unconscious. You'll hear some people referring to the collective unconscious, meaning all of our souls, all of our spirits interconnecting with each other, or perhaps with other universal forces out there when we're in the delta phase of sleep. One thing I find intriguing about that, whether you buy into that or not, it's very interesting that the delta waves, or it's intriguing that the delta waves have the highest amplitude, the highest energy output. I mean, it's still very low voltage. However, it is the highest electrical output in our brain waves is when we're in that deepest sleep. So we're unconscious, it's below subconscious, we're unconscious basically. However, the energy output is at its highest. That's very interesting to me because folks might think, well, when we're in the beta or gamma stages of our brain waveforms with the highest frequency, that's the most electrical output. But it's the inverse, actually. Those waves, yes, they're very fast frequency, many hertz cycles per second to achieve tasks and to think quickly. However, the energy associated with those waves is quite low as compared to, or the energy, you can think of that as the amplitude on the waveform, as compared to, well, the theta even, and especially the delta with those long kind of, what I describe as AM radio bands, just literally going hundreds, perhaps thousands of miles into the universe, who knows? Also interesting that, as mentioned before, when scientists observe brain waves, these waves happen concurrently in our brain. In other words, we may be in an alpha state of relaxation. However, we might have overlapping theta waves, or perhaps even very trace amounts of delta waves happening concurrently. So we're not just on one brain waveform at any time, but the brain is such a complex organ that we're still trying to understand the brain, of course. It's a very intense mystery. And these waves happen concurrently in our brain. However, the more dominant waveforms happen as described on the diagram, with the heightened states of brain activity in acute awareness, cognitive exercises, stress, reacting to stressful survival situations, and then descending right into delta with the longest waveforms, unconscious, reparative sleep, highest amplitude, highest energy. I hope you've enjoyed this video. I look forward to reading your comments below, and I wish you all a deep delta sleep this evening.